Monday, jurors should start deliberating a verdict in the trial of a man accused of killing a Jackson State student. It took just 3 days to cover the evidence in this case. Stanley Cole is accused of killing his ex-girlfriend, Latasha Norman, in 2007. Police say Cole led them to her body more than 2 weeks after she disappeared. Cole admits he killed Norman, but his lawyers argue it was an accident, not murder. 16 WAPT's Joseph Pleasant is covering the story from the Hinds County Courthouse.
Friday, prosecutors used Stanley Cole's own words and forensic pathologists to wrap up their case against him.
Jurors watched Stanley Cole confess to killing Latasha Norman Friday. Prosecutors played a videotaped confession Cole gave in 2007. In it, he told them where to find his former girlfriend, her body dumped in this wooded area of North Jackson. Jackson Police Department crime scene investigator Charles Taylor processed the scene.
At that location, there was a deceased African-American female laying face down, covered with a large piece of cardboard.
Taylor then opened an evidence bag with the actual piece of cardboard used to cover Norma's decomposing body.
About the true stuff you got.
Next, Dr. Stephen Hain took the stand. He performed Norman's autopsy. He testified Norman was stabbed to death. That conflicts with Cole's story. He hit her in the head, killing her.
What was the cause of death?
I ruled it as consistent with a stab wound of the chest.
Cole's defense attorney objected to Hain's testimony because of claims Hain gave incorrect testimony leading to the conviction of innocent defendants in the past.
It's with reasonable medical certainty, which is the highest standard one can go.
The defense called a forensic anthropologist who testified she found a bruise on Norman's head, but she could not say that killed her. After calling two witnesses, the defense rested its case.
Prosecutors say closing arguments could wrap up before lunchtime on Monday. Then jurors will start deliberating Stanley Cole's fate. Reporting from the Hinds County Courthouse, Joseph Pleasant, 16 WAPT News.